Hello everyone, my name is Alessandro Trinchera, I am in a new wonderful location and today we will talk about mainstream in science, especially in astrophysics and cosmology, and how space fans, new students, and in some cases even researchers of the academic institutions are influenced and deceived by these commercial dynamics. Big Bang, expansion of space, cosmic microwave background radiation as a relic of Big Bang, and so on. On this regard, we have to use as reference the quasi-scientific channel of Dr. Becky. Let me say, a shameful mainstream channel. I don't know what she's doing. Astrophysics for children, or she's trying to become famous. What I know is that she's a self-elected spokesperson for the mainstream community. And she's at the same time a researcher. She's a storyteller, absolutely not critical, making monologues without counterparts. She's not making science, and she's not questioning anything. Typical of the mainstream. Without her knowledge, she perfectly matches the cosmological crisis that she's living in. We will see together why. So, names like Elton Harper, Albert Sumian, Nalika, Lyndon Ashmore, Eric Lerner, Fred Hoyle, Margaret and Geoffrey Burbidge are excluded from the mainstream vocabulary, as every written article, book and conference that took place against the Big Bang, or rather against the theories with the roots in the Catholic Genesis, are completely ignored and pushed down. Even Edwin Hubble has never supported the expansion model. Never. Please don't use his name when you talk about Big Bang and expansion of space. He has nothing to do with your commercial theories. Now, having mentioned these great names, we can come back to Dr. Becky and her mainstream science. The words Dr. Becky, mainstream science, and scientific crisis are interchangeable. I will try to be a bit ironic talking about her, despite what she's saying is scientifically dramatic, and I will try to be humble and introduce some physical concepts. For instance, we will see the image of a supermassive black hole at the center of a galaxy M87, but more important, what they will never show you, we will see together a picture of the galaxy M87 at X-ray and the radio band at megabytes scale, where matter is ejected out of this galaxy instead of falling in. It is clearly an anomaly from a perspective of the academic institutions, but it is simply how the universe works. First of all, let's start from her behavior.
So as an astrophysicist, I often get asked, what do you actually do all day?
She repeatedly informs us that she's an astrophysicist. Have we, or has she, any personal doubt on it? No. Why is she saying it over and over? Moreover, why is she showing us her academic degree in her videos in the background? And can you please just simply write your academic degree in the video description or let it visible in your CV? My humble opinion is that she thinks that an academic degree gives you a sort of license to speak or to get a special status. No, it doesn't work that way. You have to prove what you say. Then, can you imagine to make a video of yourself on your desk during your working day? What would your colleague think about you? Imagine, if you want to be correct, you go to your supervisor and inform him that you are making a video of yourself in your office. In every company or institution, your supervisor will politely reject your request, thinking, what are you doing? Just concentrate on your work, please. But the best part is that she's making bloopers of herself. I'm wondering, are we watching a movie? Which mainstream role is she acting?
Because we don't get light from the black hole, we can't figure out what's going on inside it. There's nothing to reflect light back at us, or emit light, or block light, or absorb light. Something that tells us that something of some form is there. But we don't have any observational evidence.
She says that there are no proofs concerning the understanding of the black hole. Instead, there are many ones. The black hole is not an isolated entity, but it is associated to an accretion disk. The inner radius of the accretion disk corresponds to the innermost stable circular orbit in astrophysics that can be expressed in Schwarzschild radii. If we zoom out the black hole in the galaxy M87 in the X-ray and the radio field, what we see is an outflow of particles and matter. Yes, I know, they have never shown you that picture. The pull of the gravity is so strong that the matter inside the accretion disk is basically dissolved in two different ways. Thermically, with emission of radiation in ultraviolet and X-ray field, considering the accretion disk as a black body radiator. Non-thermically, the deformation of the magnetic fields and their turbulences accelerate the particles up to higher relativistic regimes. This process is the Fermi mechanism, with presence of shock waves accelerating the particles. It's not my opinion, but it is what we observe. According to the Kerr metric as solution of the Einstein's field equations for a rotating black hole, we should get a singularity where light and matter should be compressed in one point in space and time. Instead, we observe radiation and particles being pushed out of the black hole. For some, it can be really painful to hear, like hearing or videos of Dr. Becky, like I did. But we have concrete observational proofs of matter being ejected out of active nuclei, clearly related to the presence of a supermassive black hole. Concerning the picture of a supermassive black hole, what are we looking at? It is named picture of a black hole of the M87 in the radio band, but what I see is a torus of light. Are we looking at the accretion disk or a plasmoid as predicted by the plasma theory? By the way, it is another theory ignored by the mainstream science. My opinion is that whatever they detected, they reconstruct the picture of the black hole based on what they expected to see. If the accretion disk had, for instance, absurdly a square form, they would represent it in any case as a circle. Even if the plasma theory is right, and the prediction of the plasmoid is right, mainstream scientists will always describe it as a black hole. They have an interesting task to protect the findings, and deviations are not allowed.
In the entire universe, they're so bright that in some cases we can see this light that's being given off from the gas spiraling around the supermassive black hole, but it's in a galaxy so distant that the light from its stars is too faint to see, and they end up just looking like, well, incredibly bright stars themselves, because all you can see is that incredibly bright radiation coming from this point in the middle.
Or maybe quasars are closer in space, as observational data suggest. Indeed, we detect proper motion of quasars. At the cosmological distance, it would be impossible to detect. Dr. Becky knows and tells us only a part of the story. The site is sponsored by Foundix. As a good employee, she's protecting her job, and it is understandable. Elton Arp showed to the scientific community that quasars are associated to active nuclei and have an intrinsic redshift not related to the cosmological redshift. In some pictures, there is high redshift quasars even in front of a low redshift galaxy. For more information, please see my video on Elton Arp or the great videos of the channel See the Pattern.
The universe is expanding, and that it has very recently started accelerating expanding as well. This light is what we detect in the cosmic microwave background, an echo of this expansion outwards that we call the Big Bang.
She made a video named How We Plan to Solve the Crisis in Cosmology. She says how we plan. She's convinced that she's not affected by the crisis that she represents. Well, let's be honest and clear. Dr. Becky, other scientists will solve the crisis in cosmology. Black hole sun, won't you come?